Hello and welcome to the show, you guys. I'm your friendly localhood. Is that like local and neighborhood? I'm your friendly boomer. Let's just say that. Okay, so I'm lucky to be streaming. My internet had went out. That's what had happened. No, actually, I took a very long nap, like 2.5 hours, which lately I haven't been doing. Lately, I've been taking like little hour naps when I nap, which is rare now. But I took one today because I got off early, came home, I played a little bit of Palea, and then I was like, you know what? I could do a nap. So I laid down about 10. Was it 10? No, it was later than that. It was more like 11 something, because we did have a sandwich first. I broke the rule, you guy. You guy? Yeah, I have ones of viewers. What's going on with me today? Oh my God. I broke the rule. I had food and immediately went and laid down. I don't feel bad about it. I already knew I was going to lay down and take a nap. And then I went down. I was like, I could get like just a little roll up of some ham or something. So I got in the fridge and I saw all these sandwich fixings. I was like, you know what? Sandwich time it is. So we had a sandwich. We watched the girls downstairs on the little Roku while we were having our sandwich. And then we went upstairs and turned them right back on and went right to sleep. So today is Fallout Friday. I'm kind of coining it Fallout Friday. Just for now, I think we might continue to do this, like World of Warcraft the first 2 days or whatever game. And then Friday we'll do Fallout. Excuse me. So, keeping in mind that I told you guys that I was not going to do anything without you guys on the stream. I lied. No, I didn't intentionally lie. I wasn't going to advance the storyline any. I was able to do like little Nipnoid quests if I ran across them, or the occasional like little open dungeon, shall we say. What had happened was I was playing and doing just that. I was just minding my own business, not doing any of the story quests. And then I stopped for a minute and realized I had been doing the story quests. So, and the story quest wasn't, I didn't get very far. You know, I haven't gone back to Independence to meet Robbie Shaw. That's the quest we have today. All I did was I went to this area here, which is West Everett Estates. I'm on the very outskirts of it. I'm between Medford, Malden area and West Everett Estates. And right about here is Taffington Boathouse. We haven't unlocked that yet. But I got a quest to go here by Jake, the guy that got me started in Sim Settlements 2. And I had to come here and I found a non-hostile faction of super mutants. Let's let that one sink in. A non-hostile faction of super mutants. They're not hostile to us. So, yeah. And they're like, go find this person that left us. And so you have to go find the super mutant that left you. And you end up going to Rocky Narrows Park. I can't believe I remember this. It's been over a week. But you had to go to Rocky Narrows Park and you find out that the Yagwai that are nesting there killed and ate most of that super mutant. So you come back and you tell them, and they're like, okay, since you did that for us, we'll be friends. Tell you what, you can buy ASAMs off of us. I'm sorry, what? Yes, there's a non-hostile faction of super mutants who want to sell you boxes of ASAMs so you can build your entire empire. And what are they asking for in return? Chalk. They want chalk. As in C-H-A-L-K, write it on a board, chalk. All right, I'm just gonna stop now. And you can do that with that if that's what you wanna do. Needless to say, I got some chalk and I took it back over here and gave it to them, and I got, how many ASAMs did I get? 15. It's one ASAM per piece of chalk. So if you bring them one piece of chalk, you get one ASAM. Yeah. I'm sneaking because there still are hostile super mutants back that-a-way. All right, so now let's check our quests real quick. Let's go to data. Okay, we're not gonna do this one because that's really low down on the map. That one, that Somerville place. Old Guns is where we have to go to the castle and talk to Ronnie Shaw. And then miscellaneous, I overheard some settlers talking. And by overheard, I mean I just walked past them and you breadcrumb the quest. I kind of don't like that. I honestly feel like it would be better if they didn't do those. You know, or if you own, well, I don't know. I'm not completely opposed to them because sometimes you cannot pick up a quest and be like, man, I'm bored. There's nothing to do. And then you'll be in a settlement, I don't know, setting up a turret or a supply line or something. And the settlers will stop farming for a second. Like, hey, did you hear about that settlement up north where they have a farm run by ghouls? Actually, that's south. But, you know, you get my point. And then all of a sudden, it'll pop up in the corner of your screen. Map location updated. And then it shows up in your miscellaneous quest. You got to go check that place out. Okay, so we're going to go to the castle, which is actually in that direction. But since we don't want to go that way, we're going to fly. Why is it pointing in that direction when it's actually in this direction? Now, this is actually the ship that I'm supposed to be investigating, and it's actually very, very close to where I'm at. But I just don't feel like doing it yet. We might do it today, we might not, but I don't feel like doing it. And you can't make me. So we're going to travel. We love to travel. Also, you guys are super lucky that I'm here at all. Let me tell you what happened. So we got up, whatnot. She's headed towards me. I see it. That's her right there, I think. Let me just get down here for a second. Let me look around, make sure nothing's about to sneak up on me. Because there was a guy walking up and down here, and then I found him dead, but there might be others. Anyway, oh, they've put up sandbag fortifications. Okay. Oh, that's that turret detecting me. Okay, so we went downstairs and we had dinner, which was, you know, we had some baked chicken, some chicken flavored rice-a-roni, and peas. And it was delicious. And, you know, we've got Are You Being Served on YouTube downstairs, and we're feeling it, we're having fun. I've got an earbud in and I'm scrolling through TikToks. And I had paused a video because I was laughing at something on the TV, and then I happened to look down, it was like 3:48, and I'm like, I'm supposed to be streaming in 12 minutes, and I'm downstairs, and I wasn't even dressed like this. I was wearing my house clothes, as I call them. So yeah, there's that. So you guys are lucky. I ran upstairs, brushed my teeth, did my hair, put on an outfit, figured out what show I was gonna do, made a title, all that. All right, let's talk to Ronnie.
Bye.
Who are you?
I'm Ronnie Shaw, Commonwealth Minutemen. At least I was. Back before Joe Becker got himself killed and the idiots took over.
Joe Becker? Who's that?
That's just sad. General Becker used to run the Minutemen. The last real leader we ever had. After he died, there wasn't anybody left with the guts and brains to pull things together.
Ah.
What do you actually want?
Heard you were trying to get the Minutemen back on their feet. Thought I'd come see the new general for myself. So what's your story? What makes you think anybody even wants the Minutemen back?
At least we're trying to help people. Can you say the same?
Don't give me any attitude, Sonny. I've been a Minuteman longer than you've been alive.
I doubt that.
I've heard some good things about what you've been doing.
I'm 210 years old, and you're what, 50? Really infant.
We can always use more experienced soldiers.
Yeah, you're not kidding. But I had something more specific in mind. And I'm probably the only one who still remembers this. But the castle's armory was located in the West Bastion. All of our best equipment was stored in there. Weapons, ammo, schematics, you name it. Come on, I'll show you.
All right, let's go. I'll follow you for now, you hobag of an old lady. See, this is my problem with Ronnie Shaw. First of all, okay, this is my problem with Ronnie Shaw, okay? Hear me out. I don't like her. I understand her character and her, the necessity for her to be in the game. I get that. It's to forward the storyline. But here's the thing. A, she's incredibly disrespectful to someone whose only goal in life is to help. Really? You're gonna treat me like shit and all I wanna do is make everyone's lives better? No, like, nobly want to help people and you're gonna talk down to me? The second thing is, she's using her age as a crutch to be as belligerent as she wants. Hello, old entitled white Karen. And then third of all, the whole time, like from the time everything went to shit and I was frozen to now, she's done nothing. She's done nothing to help the Minutemen. Not to rebuild, not to help settlements, nothing. She's just sat on her ass and been a cranky old lady. Think about that. I got thawed out and immediately went to action. She's been alive this whole time and she's done nothing. Think about that. But she has the gall
like it might still be intact.
To be the bitch she is.
Door still sealed. Bastion hasn't collapsed. Trick now is finding a way in.
Okay.
Do you know some way to open this door?
No. And even if we could blast it open, we'd probably destroy what's inside while we're at it. If you can't go through, go around. Let's have a look at the northeast bastion.
I really need to do some work here in the castle. God, she's so slow. But she's old and her bones are brittle. She's leaving soon. We'll just say that. Come on, Ronnie. Okay, so we're gonna find this place here blocked off. As we knew, this ain't our first rodeo.
This was the general's quarters. Used to be a tunnel leading from here to the armory. This tunnel's blocked by this rubble. We'll have to find some way to clear it.
Book it!
Let's get down there and see if there's still a way through.
Come on, girl, let's go. There she is. I was like, come on, girl. Let's turn that light off.
Pretty dark down here. We better watch our step.
You think? What are those? Oh, cannonballs. I was like, what's those glowing green balls? Alien scrotums?
Over.
Oh my god. Oh, I didn't set it off because I'm sneaking. Okay. Okay. Calm yourself, honey. Let's go. Thanks for blowing me up, by the way. Thank God I was in God mode, or I'd have been killed. Okay, obviously nothing this way. Let's go this way. She'd set that shit off. She's gonna be the one to set everything off. I feel like, oh. Ronnie! God, she's so annoying, isn't she?
In a minute, man.
I'm trying not to set off that frag mine, and I knew Ronnie would do that. Alright, I gotta be able to see. I can't see shit. Alright, now we're back. Ronnie, come on now. Don't be a douche canoe. I know what's coming, and you guys do too. You know that giant ass Decepticon, a unit of a machine is coming. We are not touching anything we don't have to right now. Sorry, my eyes are killing me. I'm having eye issues right now with my allergies. I'm really sorry. I know it's probably gross to see you, for you guys to see me scratching at them like that, but I had to. Sorry about it. What is that floating in midair? There's literally something right there. I don't know what it is, but it's floating. All right, we know it's coming. What weapons do I have on me? This might be a problem. I forgot about this. I mean, I didn't forget. I knew it was coming, but I didn't think. This does 43, this does 42. Maybe I should attack it with a pair of knuckles. I just beat the thing to submission. All right, missile launcher. I don't really wanna blow a bunch of stuff up. Where's my, I have a quick hardened combat shotgun. We'll try that.
Well, I'll be. I would've never guessed the sergeant's.
All right, we're gonna go for the head, people. There's no reason why this is gonna go any other way. And then, bam, 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 boom. This guy is coming for me. Sarge is badass. I really wish that there was a way of... Oh, you know what? Now I can get to his head. I wish there was a way of, like, shutting him down and then repairing him later to where he works for you. That would be amazing. I tried to get away from him as quick as I could. I didn't want Ronnie getting caught in the blast. It would have been funny though if like that old lady went flying across the screen and hit the wall. I'm not wishing that on real old ladies, just her, because she's a bit of a bitch. I can't stand her. I don't even know what she's saying. I can't listen to her because the damn music's so freaking loud. Okay, so now I'm gonna grab everything that I can. Because why not? Because why not, you know? Because why not? What is this? I don't know what that is, but it's driving me nuts. All right. There's another one right there. What is going on? I keep thinking, okay, here's something funny. I keep thinking I have to go up to the different workbenches. I've been playing a little bit of... I've been playing a little bit of Fallout 76 in my off time, so I keep wanting to run up to the workbenches and use them to scrap all my junk to reduce weight. And then I have to tell myself I don't have to do that anymore. It's crazy how different Fallout games, you'll get on one and then muscle memory will kick in and you're like, oh, I don't have to do that. Damn, that's a crater in the ground. Grabbing all of the cannonballs. I may or may not even need them, but I am gonna go ahead and grab them. Just in case. You know what I'm saying? Just in case. All right, there's the entrance. Now we're back.
Something that happened before. through.
Girl, honey, calm the fudge down. I'm just grabbing anything that I might possibly need. This is a really good cap. Can I wait? No, there's. They need to turn this down here into a workshop. I'm just saying, like, this would be a really good location for a workshop, honestly. It's a little tiny bit of a maze, but if you could unblock all of the tunnels. I mean, this is a decent sized little area here. You could unblock everything. And use it in a constructive way. All right, we're in. There's old Becker. No, McGann, my bad, McGann. We'll take that. You know what, we'll take all of it. It's mine now, I'm the general now. This is also, if I'm not mistaken, the only location in the game where you can get the Amontillado wine. Also, this right here is a throwback to the Count of Amontillado. And there should be a plaque explaining some of that, but there isn't. I don't feel like reading all that right now. I might come back later off camera and read it. All right, so we are now going into the West Bastion. Jeez. Now have access to the West Bastion.
What kinds of goodies are left.
And it's lit up too. All right, we've got some unwired defense turrets.
Excellent. The armory's still intact. Everything we need.
Some weapons, some mini nukes. We've got fusion cells. Schematics. Here we go. Artillery supplies. We'll grab that as well.
Artillery?
Great big guns. Blow up our enemies from miles away. Any of this ringing a bell?
Yeah, isn't that what started all this?
And let's get going. Don't forget to grab some smoke grenades, too.
Yeah, she wants us to be able to blow up our enemies from miles away. Isn't that what started Fallout? Just saying. There's a fat man there. Medium, a beam splitter, duct tape, I'll take that. To avoid interfering with quest completion. That's fine. So now there's a city plan for Sim Settlements 2 here. My thing is, I don't know if I want Sim Settlements 2 to build here. I think I might want to build here. No, what we're going to do, well, yeah, what we're going to do is... Huh, what are we going to do? I'm just looking real quick at something. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go into build mode real quick and we can't scrap that. We can't scrap that. That sucks.
Bye.
Looks like you've got everything we need. As soon as you get some artillery built, we'll do a test fire to calibrate.
Okay, let's do it. We're gonna put one right here where there was artillery, and that will give us a clear line of fire to this whole area here. Okay, all right, not mad about it. All right, let's build an artillery. I also want to say, for those of you who have not heard me talk about it, I've been playing a little bit. I'm gonna have to go all the way around. I've been playing a little bit of Baldur's Gate 3, and by a little bit, I mean I made a new character, and just got myself going, basically. And like literally just woke up from the pod. Like I'm still in the tutorial area of the game. And the reason being for that, even though I had already been playing a little bit of it and had made it off the little Nautilus ship and onto the beach, the reason why I'm no longer there and why I'm starting over is because you have to. The devs were very quick to point out that the early access build of the game and the final version build of the game are two completely different things. The early access build of the game that I was playing was like 70 something gigs. The full game is 120 something, if I'm not mistaken. It's almost double in size. And I will say, now I will say that this build, the actual like 1.1 build or whatever, 1.0 build, whatever you want to call it, it is so much better in terms of stability. It responds better. There's a whole bunch of stuff just in building your character that wasn't there before. It is pricey. But if you guys are interested in it, it's a really good game. It's been in early access for like 3 or 4 years. People are like, it's never coming out. And then lo and behold, the indie studio that made it put it out like they said they would, and it's becoming the benchmark standard. It is. Like, every game company is pissed because they're like, we can't compete with that. You can. You choose not to. I said what I said. Alright. Wait. What am I supposed to do?
I think we're really starting to make a difference.
I made them. Wait, who are all these people? Just showing up. What time is it in the game? 12:01. Wait, am I supposed to... Oh, wait. I'll have to assign the artillery. Okay. Unassigned, we can fix that. All right, you're going to go on this one over here. She about to become an artillery gunner, I'm excited to say. Oh, not there. Here we go. All right, that one is now assigned. My defense just went up 38. You're about to become one too. What's crazy is if I do decide, you guys, to make this this settlement run by Sim Settlements 2, we're gonna run into a situation where these artillery that I made are going to not be here probably. They're probably gonna be put somewhere else. I could be wrong. All right, I now have two artillery things set up. Let's do this.
Hey.
Gosh darn, it's good to see artillery here again. So here's the thing about the big guns. They can't fire at anything too close, but their range is impressive. That's what the smoke grenades are for. Toss one of those at the bad guys. If we have artillery in range, you'll confirm over the radio and target our fire on your smoke. But first, we better do a test fire. Make sure we're hitting what we're aiming at. You see that little building over there? We'll use that for our aiming point. Keep your radio on and tuned to Radio Freedom so we can confirm we're ready.
Okay, so first things first, let's grab the smoke grenades. I see a nuclear grenade. Gamma gun. Frag grenade. Huh. Alright, let's... It says throw a smoke flare. Hold on. It's tuned to Radio Freedom. And then we will grab a smoke flare. I don't see them anywhere. Do you guys? Do we have a flare gun? Artillery smoke grenade. Okay. Here we go. I really hope I don't get demonetized for playing this music. I don't want to do this, but... Hello? I did it. This is weird. Maybe I'm supposed...
Okay, we've got your smoke on the target. You might want to stand back.
I tried.
No, just in case.
Something. Oh shit, there's more. Okay. We brought the smoke, ladies and gentlemen. That was a lot more satisfying than I thought it was gonna be. Okay. Now my question is, did all the stuff that... Jesus, there's more? How many? All right, that's enough. That's enough. You killed the poor defenseless trucks. You killed them. I'm getting out of here. Jesus. That's enough. There comes more. That is kind of cool looking, though. That is kind of cool looking. If anything was alive then, it's dead now. That's so, I mean, they're destroying everything. They've decided we're gonna kill every vehicle in that parking lot. Even the, oh, you can actually see them fire off. That's kind of cool. That was the building itself. Look at the ash and stuff flying out. That's crazy. Jesus. I mean, they're destroying the entire parking lot. I'm gonna run around in the parking lot. I mean, I am in God mode. They're gonna go after that car next, I bet you.
That looked good from here.
Okay, we got it.
Now got artillery support. Use it wisely.
Okay, so they didn't knock anything off the countertops. Isn't that crazy? All right, we're gonna turn off that radio. All right. So, okay. So what, okay, it's pointing us in another direction. Oh, I have to talk to Preston Garvey. Imagine that. All right. Let's run back to, oh, I did make Preston, you guys. I made him the mayor of Sanctuary. And so it tore everything down that I previously built, of course, and rebuilt everything, well, the foundation of it anyway. And slowly but surely, things have been starting getting built there because we have several settlers. You know, I've given them a bunch of resources, so it's going to look different. One second. I just realized something. Audio. I gotta turn, radios off for now. It's still going. Let's turn them off completely to where you can't hear anything. Oh my gosh. It's, you can still hear it. Let's turn that off. Okay. And you're gonna see going into these buildings some weird looking things. They're gonna be set up a little different. Who is this? A Minuteman, okay. I'm just looking around real quick. I like looking around every time I come back to Sanctuary because it's always something different. This here is a little recreational plot. They've got a little bird bath here set up with a bench and a newspaper, and eventually that swing will get hung back up, I'm sure, off of there, I'm assuming. They got a little sandbox here for the kiddies with one of those little teeter-totter things on springs. A fun fact, in Fallout 76, you can build these and actually get on them, and then you can go to picture mode and catch yourself on them. I've got a picture of my character on one of those things just going to town in it. What else do we have? We've got some stacked... I guess windmills, we'll call them windmills. Look at that moon, you guys. Isn't that lovely? That is just lovely. Can we shoot the moon? We'll see. We've got streetlights up everywhere, and we've got Jenny back here for some reason. And, oh, a melon farm. Hello. Someone's patched in the holes in the walls with wood. Somewhat. Let's see, can we look in here? This just looks normal. Some of the rooms look vanilla, but are being lived in, and then other rooms haven't been touched yet. This one in particular hasn't. But this person here set up a little living quarters. They got a little eating station right here with a table and some cinder blocks and some moldy food. Some shelving up on the walls, a bedside table and a bed. So they've got like a little bit going on. And then this room is very normal-ish. We'll say that. We'll turn off that radio. I had it running for the last couple of days when I've been on the game because I like having music to listen to. That fades in and out as you get closer or far away from it. What do we have over here? We've got... Oh, I forgot about this. This is so cool. Check out. It's a bar, you guys, with no lighting. I mean, let me turn the light off. Like, it's pitch black, and this guy is sitting here in the dark getting drunk. I mean, he must be depressed. He's a visiting farmer.
Yeah.
Okay, that means he's not an actual settler. And then right next to it, I love this. This is their little casino. It's literally a casino. They built Baby Vegas here, basically. I love that. I think that's so cute. This is a library, actually, believe it or not. They got a little reading area here, some filing, and then they've got just a handful of books. That's their library. Now, over time, again, these buildings will upgrade. They'll get taller. They'll get better maintained. They'll have much better decorations. The decorations will upgrade as well. So don't get like, oh, that looks awful. Don't think what you're seeing now is the finished product. Over time, things get upgraded. Like, for instance, they've put some walling up right here, some outside wall right here on the other side of this carport here, and enclosed it, and it's now a shop that deals with power armor. Now, that's my power armor right there. Once the settler that gets assigned to it is there, you can actually buy power armor parts from them, and mods, if I'm not mistaken. There's a little staircase here that leads up to this floor here, which I'm sure there's going to be something up here eventually, and then, of course, the power supply. This is still technically a little, garden area, although I don't think anyone's gardening in it right now. This is like a public speaking area. And basically, it's where your settlers go sometimes to level up their charisma. Yeah, you can actually, your settlers can actually level up their own stats. They all have stats now. Now, just like in Sim Settlements 1, all of the named NPCs that you can recruit can become leaders of your settlements, right? They all have specific traits. They have strengths and they have weaknesses. But you can also find just a generic-ass settler, one that is not named. Where's the damn gate? Is there a gate? Yeah, I can get in through here. You can actually just assign a settler as the mayor of a settlement. This is a scrap area here, I think. Or this might be water or something. It's municipal. And then this is a caravan place. This is the little thing that goes on top of a Brahmin. There's his little desk. So this place is starting to like liven up a little bit. There's more. I'm kind of like a lot of the settlers are actually living inside the homes, the actual pre-existing homes. Oh, I was supposed to find Preston. I was fixing to leave. I was supposed to find Preston, but you can actually assign any random settler that you want as that's that thing right there. This guy here is literally living under a table. This is actually Marcy, isn't it? Nope, it's just a settler. I thought it was Marcy. I was like, serves her right. Wait, is that gun? Can I grab that gun? I can't grab that gun. She's living in a kitchen. I mean, it's not the worst place to live if you think about it. You have the ability to prep your food. You have a table to eat off of or store stuff on. Sleeping bag underneath it. So if anything falls, like the roof caves in, you're protected from it. It's not the worst situation, actually, if you think about it. I mean, it's not ideal, but it's not the worst. Okay, so there's Preston sleeping on the floor, as any good dog should. Where are all my named settlers? Let's wake him up. He's the mayor, and he's sleeping on the floor. That's hilarious. They relegate him to sleeping on the floor.
I've got to hand it to you, General. You've really turned things around for the Minutemen. I never thought I'd see the day that the Minutemen had artillery support again. We should see about building them at all our settlements to expand our coverage. And Ronnie Shaw returns. She's something else, isn't she?
We got the old guns achievement just now, you guys. It didn't pop up on stream, but it popped up in the corner of my screen. What do you think of her?
What do you think of her? People like her. She comes across pretty hard-ass. But she's one of the goons. I'd heard stories about her from the old-timers, but I didn't know she was still around.
What is he doing?
The fact that she's come back to the Minutemen means we must be doing something right. Now, before I forget, I've got something else for you to look into.
Of course.
I'll mark it on your map. We can use all the support we can get. So see what you can do to help.
Green Top Nursery, isn't that the one that's run by robots? That one there we don't hate. We love that for me. We love that for me. And it's local. I can get behind that. Going all the way down to Somerville Place when I haven't done any of the quests in the northern quadrant of the map, let's worry about ourselves before we worry about our neighbors. I'll just say that. Alright, so I don't know if I've already done it here at Red Rocket, but I'm going to assign someone. Actually, I think I have assigned someone as mayor. I've just got to give them a bunch of supplies. So I'm going to run over here to the workshop. I'll just take all. And then I'm going to go to the desk and manage resources. All right, let's donate items. And we're going to... Actually, you know what? What I've started doing is putting weapons, gear, all kinds of stuff in there. I really should have done this off camera. I'm really sorry, you guys. I didn't think about it till just now. I'm gonna keep that one. Just for me, just for now. Just for this. Apparel. Let's drop off all the leather stuff that I have. You know what? I'm just gonna drop off all the non-raider items. And junk. All right, here we go. basically all I do is this. I just drop everything off. And see, what it is the desk will automatically do the calculations for how much it's going to take to build the entire foundation for the settlement, right? And then I didn't mean to drop that off. Whatever it doesn't need, it will throw into either your possession or the workbench, okay? Now that it has, I believe, everything it needs, return the remainder to you. It gave me back the pistol. It's giving me back, like, a lot of stuff. All right. So we're going to activate led by Settler. Select city plan. I believe we only have the one. Right? Let's go to, truck stop basics. Okay, use this city plan. It says not enough resources. I forgot it does need 20 ASAM sensors. Not enough resources. Cancel. I don't have but 15. So there are a couple of places out in the world that you can find ASAM sensors. This is actually an agricultural plot. I built it and then assigned it. And then these here are the homes. We've got someone here living in just a junk pile. They're eating Deathclaw eggs for dinner, so they can't be doing too bad. And then you got this dude here who's against. I'm not going to knock them for sleeping on the floor. I'm not going to. Why would I? I mean, it's not their fault. They only have so much. Wasn't there somebody walking around out here a minute ago? Thought there was. Okay, so I need ASAM sensors. We're going to go looking for them. Oh, I just remembered. I'm also supposed to listen to Jake's frequency, his private frequency. Yeah, I gotta turn radios back on. This is the problem with streaming, you guys. You have to tweak things constantly, or at least turn this back up. All right, let's go to Jake's private frequency.
Hello? Is this working? Hey, Slick. I hope you're seeing this. And Tracer? You can hear this coming back to the hardware store. That's what you use on the telephone. Is this even broadcasting? Oh, wait. I just got...
This has been a pre-recorded message. Message repeats.
Started. Well, well, well. All right, let's turn that back off. It sounded like he said he got some news. But I'm not 100% for sure. Yep, there he is. All right, so I think the place has... The cell is reset. I'm not seeing any raider bodies. And it looks like the sandbags have respawned. And I'm not seeing any exploded anything. And I'm not seeing the dead Deathclaw. So we're good. There's still a dead Minuteman. So that doesn't get cleaned up. That feels great. We're just going to let them decompose. There's the box that we got from the Air Force satellite place. USAF. What's his face? Jake here, just standing outside in the middle of the road drinking coffee. Oh, I'm standing up against the light. What do their light things look like? Oh, these are just the crosswalks, and that's the actual light. You know what? I'm 1,000% sure they didn't have this back in the 50s, and the aesthetic is supposed to be based off 1950s US aesthetics. The buildings, yes. The vehicles, yes. But that right there looks a little bit newer in tech. I'm just saying. Put my gun away and talk to Jake.
Hey there.
Howdy, Slick. Good to see you again.
How are you doing?
I gotta say, I'm doing pretty good. As you can see by the crate, I managed to get the comma back. Although it wasn't easy, let me tell you. I've got the hub inside if you'd like to see it.
I don't see why not.
All right, follow me.
All right, let's go have a look-see. There's a boss chest right there. And oh my goodness.
Ain't she a beaut? Although sadly not ready for service just yet. In fact, I couldn't even turn it on. But I have been able to give the old gal a good going over. Got a rough understanding of the hardware.
Wow.
You got my attention.
Well, judging by the internals, this thing mostly appears to be a giant processor. My guess is that it operates as a kind of ASAM switchboard, connecting and communicating with the sensors. Which makes sense, really. I mean, it is called the comm hub. Now, if we could get sensors connected and communicating, that really would open up our options. Let us do some cool things.
Like what?
What do you mean by that?
Well, for example, remote management, mass software updates, division of settlement labor, and the obvious one, better communications. Now, to you, that last thing may not sound like much, but trust me, better communications is something we want.
Agreed.
So I think it's in our best interest to get this comm hub running. Really begin to rebuild the Commonwealth.
It's doing that thing where it's timing out. I've got to...
I'm on board. When do we start?
In order to get things going, first, we need to turn this thing on. And for that, we're going to need some serious power. And I'm afraid my little generator just ain't going to cut it. However, as luck would have it, just a couple of feet below us is all the power we could need.
Really?
Concord has a municipal plutonium.
No!
We use to power every building in town. You get some real power flowing again, all you need to do is turn it on. That is, if you wouldn't mind helping out.
I don't mind!
I'm on it. It's as good as done.
I knew you'd help. You'll have to discover a way into the old service tunnels running under Concord. Once you're down there, find something that looks like a big old generator. Do what you need to start it up, then head on back.
Okay. So, okay, wait. Wait 1 second. Does that mean that if I power up Concord, that the lights are going to start coming back on? Some of the buildings might get opened up. That might be why we're not allowed to use anything like Concord Revisited or the Beantown Interiors Project or Stumble Upon Interiors. You know what I'm saying? Like, that might be why we can't use some of the those mods. Some of these buildings might get opened up. That will be interesting. All right, we're going to go into sneak mode and pull our gun out. Sorry, my elbow is really itching. My eczema is flaring up. I'm trying really hard to not let it bother me. Now, I did already go through here and kill everything. That being said, you guys know after a cell reset, things can pop back up. There's something right there. Oh, there's something in here. Okay, so what do we got back here? And a pin. All right, so wait. What's up there? Long John's. Can't get up there. What if I jump? Wait. Aha. Caps. Oh, day tripper and a teddy bear. There was literally no other way up here than jumping. That's bonkers. It doesn't look like the enemies have respawned though. I swear I hear rad roaches crawling, but come on, get in there. Maintenance. Okay. Maintenance tunnels. This is exciting. I've already killed shit in here once while I was exploring. Wait, I just saw a dead body. Minutemen jumpsuit. So we've had Minutemen down here before. Ooh, a baseball. Now I found this one earlier, but this one here is new. I think some of the stuff doesn't get left in here. Ooh. Okay, nothing jumped out. That thing's dead. I don't think they're gonna do anything new, really. I think this is all good. Lunch pail's empty. See a light bulb, I'll take that. It's a big giant plutonium well, and it looks busted as hell. I'm just gonna say that. Now, according to the last time I was in here, oh, that's brain fungus. Like, all this looks busted. And there is a generator down here. This is weird. Okay, so according to this, I believe I'm... says, I hooked up a gas generator to help kickstart the reactor just in case it stalls again. And if the gas generator stops working, I don't know. Kick it. Oh, and then hit that big red button. I keep forgetting that part. Oops, I... hit a button I didn't need to. All right, so let's hit the button. All right, so it didn't work. So, wait, what is this? Nothing in there, okay. Let's go, I haven't been down there, I don't think. Maybe I have. All right, let's kick the generator. Okay. All right, let's push the button again. Ladies and gentlemen, we are in business. Concord has power. Concord has power. All right, let's get the hell out of Dodge. Quickest way is, yeah, through here. Concord is gonna have power. It'd be crazy if everything was lit up and it's not, but it would have been crazy. I'm trying to remember the quickest way out of here is up these stairs. That light is green now. Wasn't it red before? Here we go. We're out here. There's multiple entrances and exits to the sewer system here. We have lights, you guys. The lights came on. It works. The lights are on in Concord. And there's the plutonium well, and there you can see the lines run to it. So, that's pretty dope. We have lights. That's kind of cool. The lights in front of the museum are lit up, you guys. And the ones up there. That's so cool. We have lights. I know it's so stupid for me to be that excited. I want to look around for a second. The little lights down the alley back here, I noticed, are also lit up. That's so cool. That's so cool. This is the kind of stuff, you guys don't understand, I have real bad OCD. Oh, I about knocked my drink over. I have really bad OCD, and one of the things that I like about my job and I find fulfilling is I go in every day and there are things wrong, and I go in and I fix them. And while that sounds like, oh my God, you have the worst job, you're always having to fix problems, that's the way my brain operates to find happiness. What's up, new follower? Athena? We're just gonna call you Athena. You know, that's a really cool name. But yeah, I go in, I fix all the mistakes and messes, and while they tend to be the same things every week, it's not like every day I'm doing the same thing over and over and over. Each day I do something different on a structured environment. So every Monday I have the same problems to fix. Every Tuesday I have different, but the same problems every Tuesday to fix, and so on and so on and so on. And for my OCD, that is the best medicine. I get it all worked out of my system, so when I come home, I can just relax and de-stress and just, like, I'm fine. So this right here is like me, this is like my crazy to the nth degree. I'm not sure about this wire coming from out of literally the windowsill of that building. That feels like a fire hazard. I'm just gonna say that. But that being said, this looks amazing. I like the fact that there are lights now. Let's talk to Jake and see what he has to say. Oh, I'm so excited.
You should have all the power you need now.
Yeah, I noticed. When the power came back, it blew out half the bulbs in here. It's gonna be a pain in the ass to replace those.
Not really, I can find them.
The thing is, we now have power.
Will it be enough?
I don't know. Let's go find out. All right then, let's try powering this thing up. Now let's see here.
Okay, I'm here. Yeah, I'm so excited. We got power run back to Concord.
Okay.
Just looking.
Connect this there. Move that. Bypass this. I think we're ready to give this a go. Best if you stand back.
Okay, bye. And now Jake's dead. No. No, he's not dead.
Okay. That didn't exactly go
check.
To plan.
Check out the mannequin behind him got burnt up.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. To be honest, I was kind of worried this might happen. I've been sitting around unused for so long, and so many of its parts have degraded. Seems even with enough power, there's no getting around blowing out capacitors and pair of semiconductors. It was worth a try.
So, what now?
Give me a day or two. Hey, back at school, I got some of the busted parts. Clean a few tubes, it might be enough.
Bless you.
I know it may not seem like it, but this was a step forward.
You're okay?
Sure. I'm fine. Oh, wait, before you go. Here, take this.
I can now build small jury-rigged defense plots which allow for basic defenses to be... Oh, so now I can build defense plots. Okay.
After all the trouble we've had with raiders, I started wondering if ASAMS could offer a solution. Now, I've not had the time to put some together myself. Been too busy with the comm hub. But what you have there are instructions on how to jury-rig together a sort of defense plot. It's not very advanced, but should at least deter attacks from some of the small fry.
Okay. Excuse me.
Thank you. I'm sure that'll come in handy.
Technically, it's just a creative use of an ASAN program with an industrial plot. But by making the changes listed on that piece of paper, the ASAN should be able to guide someone to build something a little more defensive.
Defensive.
After that, it's just a matter of basic maintenance by whomever was assigned to it.
Sounds good.
I'm gonna be busy with the comm hub for a while, so I won't have time to demonstrate. But I'm sure you'll be able to figure it out yourself.
Maybe.
Thanks for your help today. I'll put out a radio message again when I've got news. Take care out there.
Okay, so now, let's see if he has any spare ASAMs. I hear a radio going that I can't turn off. There we go. He doesn't have any spare ASAMs. He really doesn't. Let's look upstairs, just in case. Nope. Okay, the sun's come up. Oh, check it out. He's starting to build his house up a little bit. It's got like a little mini weapons workbench. He's put up a little bit of a wall here. He's storing some stuff on the roof. He's finally starting to take some pride. Oh, he's got like a little armor workbench here. He's got like a whole little studio apartment basically in some kind of sign. I guess he's been shooting at it. Looks like gunfire has hit it. That's so cool. That's so cool. Okay, so we have to... that's it, really. Ghoul problem at Green Top Nursery. No, Green Top Nursery is not... Is it? No, Green Top Nursery is the one right outside. Oh, yeah. Let's go to Malden Middle School, and then we'll go talk to those people. You people... I feel like I'm missing something. Like I did something wrong or something. Other than my entire life. No, wait, what is this over here by this toilet? Which, by the way, putting a indoor toilet on the outside, that's genius. Now I'm going to have to build an outhouse inside something. You know what? We do have to sneak past this sinkhole. It's so weird seeing none of these buildings opened up. I'm so used to, like, some of my other mods having content here that this is kind of disheartening. I'm very upset about it. I'm used to there being people and turrets and quests there, and now there's none of that. All right, let's talk to the settlers at Greentop Nursery. Hello, I'm looking for Louis Macaro. Should we do this entire stream in French today? Bonjour, je m'appelle Daniel.
Hey.
You're with the Minute
Men. No, we're not
gonna
go.
What seems to be the problem?
A pack of feral ghouls has holed up nearby, and some of them have started wandering out lately. If more of them start wandering out this way, we may be overrun. We need someone to clear them out.
I'm on it. It's as good as done.
I'll be glad to have them gone.
Okay. Hello, Mr. Puppy Dog. I see you. Gotcha. Are there more of you coming? Them boys usually hunt in packs. I'm not gonna grab the mute fruits. I feel like that's, uh-oh. Wait, that's the scribe. Oh, you guys.
Good day to you, stranger. You look like someone that appreciates the utility of a good set of armor.
Sure.
Sure. I'm always looking for good armor.
My selection is a bit limited right now, but take a look.
Okay, here we go. All right. Oh, he doesn't have the armor he's wearing. First of all, let me just ask this. Who the hell is this guy? His name is the Scribe, right? But he's a traveling merchant. That's not how the Brotherhood of Steel operates. He's willing to sell products to just anyone that walks up. That is not how the Brotherhood of Steel operates. So is he actually a member of the Brotherhood of Steel? Is he excommunicado? Like, what is going on here? I need this information. I'm just glad because he's here and I gotta get rid of some shit. I'm just gonna get rid of quite a few things real quick. You guys just bear with. I knew you were gonna hear me saying that. I was kinda hoping you did. Daddy Joseph has arrived, you guys.
Hello, everyone.
Oh, you didn't have to say it like that.
How are we today?
We're all right. We're having our whatchamacallit and a cream soda. Mm-hmm. And we got a new follower, so we're doing great.
That's great.
I'm gonna keep the chess pieces because when you here's a pro tip for any of you guys. When you scrap like arm and leg pieces, you just get like leather, cloth, and steel. But when you craft chest pieces, you get those whatever, you know, like if it's a raider chest piece, you get leather and I think a piece of steel, but you also get adhesive. So keep the chest pieces and just scrap them for adhesive. Especially when you're lower level and it's very hard for you to come across adhesive. Until you've got like some adhesive farming going if you're not using mods or console commands. Also, one more thing. And this is just a nitpicky thing and I'm really sorry to bring this up and sound like I'm being mean and I promise I'm not. It's adhesive, not adhesive. I hate when people mispronounce words. It's adhesive. It's plainly in how it's spelled, adhesive. It's literally how it's spelled. That's just one of my things. I can't stand for someone to sit there and call it adhesive. I there's so many YouTubers that just say adhesive. I mean absolutely no disrespect, but it's like English is their first language. That's their primary language and they still can't pronounce it correctly. I give leeway to people who English is not their native language. I'm like, you know, English is my native language, and so I struggle with Spanish and French. That being said, I know a little bit of it because I'm Cajun, I'm Creole. I know I don't have an accent. I've worked really hard to not have an accent. Well, I say that. I don't hear the accent, and people around me don't hear the accent. But people from the interwebs, from all over the world, hear my accent, and I sound like a country bumpkin. I'm sorry about that. I'm very sorry about that. Can't help it. I'm keeping my sack hoods as well because the bog, you know, the cranberry settlement, the slog, that's what it's called, not the bog, the slog. I'm just gonna say that. They, you know, I give them sack hoods. I don't require them to wear them or anything, but I give them sack hoods and like wigs and masks and sunglasses because sometime or another you have to leave your settlement for something. And they're not comfortable being out in the real world. So in my head canon, they have something to cover up in case they so choose. That's just me trying to be nice. And if it's the wrong way of being nice, I apologize. I'm just gonna say that. All right, let's get rid of all of this. I just made 1,500 gold caps off this guy. You know what's, what's funny is when I'm talking, well, or when I'm playing Fallout 4, I always mess up and want to say gold, but then when I turn around and play Skyrim, I want to mess up and turn around and say caps. There's no happy medium with me. I'm crazy no matter what, so I'm not going to, oh shit. Where's the other one? Where did he go? Oh, I see him. I knew I was gonna get attacked. I was ready. I just sold a bunch of shit and now I'm turning around and getting more. That's nuts. I'm more interested in that hub flower than I am actually in what I just killed. All right, let's do this. Let's do this. We are headed to the USAF, right? No, we're headed to the National Guard. That's where we're headed. To the National Guard. Is that a... It is. Nope, I thought I saw a roach. My bad. I thought I saw a glowing roach. I was about to shoot it and kill that truck. All right, here we go. I don't really hate this location. I'm not fond of this location, but I don't hate it. I'm detected? How the hell am I detected? That's how. So, bitch, I dare. What's shooting at me? Oh. I'm like, I dare any person to like bum rush me, right? And I have a freaking combat rifle and I'm unloading it on them. No pun intended. And then they just start dodging bullets. This is not the Matrix. That's not how this works. That's not how any of this works. Just so you guys will know, and your children will one day know, that is not how any of that works. All right, there are frag mines there too. Okay. I've become way too reliant on the VAT system, and I'm trying to get better. But I do use it to look and see if there are mines out. That is literally the best way, because sometimes you won't see the mines until all of a sudden you're stepping on them and boom, boom, boom. Just looking. You know what? Let's go upstairs. We're gonna go up on the roof and pick off all the bad guys that we can. Also, I want to make an observation real quick, you guys. I never played a Bethesda product until Skyrim came out. Never. I never played any of the Elder Scrolls games until Skyrim came out. I never played any of the Fallout games until Fallout 4 came out. So, these were my first forays, and I feel like they were spectacular forays into the Bethesda universes. But I've since gone back and I've started playing Fallout 3, and even though Bethesda didn't make it, I've started also playing New Vegas. And I can see so much of the DNA of those old games in these new games. I just noticed these roof pieces here, these right here, are also in Fallout 3. Gotcha. I knew there was one in there. Ooh, I forgot about these Vault Tech containers having stuff in them. I really did forget about that. I remembered it earlier, but then I forgot it again because, you know, I'm crazy. And I have the memory span of a gnat. I could have sworn there was more than that, but I thought maybe I thought wrong. Also, let me just say this. They do it in Fallout 76, I believe. But I would love it if, like, you could trick ghouls into running around and they trigger all the little landmines. I mean, it would blow the whole place up to smithereens and back. But I would like to see them being able to set off... I forgot about that one. I would like to see them being able to set off the frag mines and stuff that are laid out. I know there's more than that. Oh yeah, there's literally one right here in front of me. I didn't even see it. See? That's why one of the first things I do is start working on my sneak ability. Not necessarily because I like sneaking, although it is probably the handiest skill to have. It's more because it's easier to not blow yourself up every 5 seconds. Alright, I think there's another one in this bus because my sneak meter is still pinging a little bit. So we're going to check the bus and then we're going to go check that building out over there. I always try to check all the outlying buildings before... Nope, it was just the one. My bad. I always check the outlying buildings before I enter the main building. Because you guys know, once we're in that building, we're in the shit. So, are we just sinking vehicles into concrete? Is that who we are? Oh, speaking of who we are. Okay, so a little backstory. I was trying to find an outfit for my birthday. Remember, I told you the story how my big giant ass broke my favorite pair of shorts that were brand new. Anyway, while I forgot to tell you guys about this, while I was trying to figure out what I was going to wear, I was going through some undershirts because I didn't want to sweat through because we live in the South. I didn't want to sweat through and be a big steaming mess, you know? So, I was going through my undershirts to find the nicest one. Because you guys know, when you work a lot and you don't spend a lot of money on clothes, you have undershirts that you wear every day. And then you have your nice undershirts. The ones that have the least amount of stains and no holes or anything. And they're the whitest ones if you have white undershirts. So, I was doing that. I was looking for... Is that a... Wait. Legendary Rabid Radstag. We are so not concerned, honey. The way this body was curled up for a second there, I was like, that's a ghoul, but it wasn't apparently. Anyway, so I noticed I had, matter of fact, I have it right here. I threw it away right here. You guys are gonna see, okay, I'm really sorry. We're gonna pause the stream for a second. Ugh, I can't believe I'm doing this. I'm gonna show them the t-shirt. Remember the t-shirt from yesterday?
Oh.
So, okay. Yes. So, I noticed this. I had the shirt. It's just a plain white t-shirt. It's still semi-folded. I'm going to unfold it. I had it laid out on the bed. Oh, it smells like my closet. It smells so pretty and clean. Anyway, I had it laid out on the bed. And I noticed, I was like, okay, one armpit here is just a normal armpit, slightly stained, but I mean, it, you know, it is what it is. But the other one is... I didn't even notice this until, like, you notice the difference in color? One's that color, one's that color. Mm-hmm. This color under here, under this arm, has this weird, I don't know if it's picking up very well, it's this weird pink color under the arms. And it's saturated. I mean, saturated with glitter. Glitter! And I'm like, what the hell? So I checked the other side. And it's also got a decent fair amount of glitter. In fact, I've got it on my hands now. I don't know if you guys can see it. But there's glitter under there. So I started looking at some of my other undershirts. And there's like one or two also a little tiny bit glittery. But most of them don't have that. So I'm like, what the hell is going on? So I showed it to Joseph yesterday, I think. And threw the shirt away because I'm not going to keep it. It's gross. It's clean. It's actually clean. It's just stained from sweat and glitter, apparently. And I was like, I don't understand what's going on. Why there's glitter under there? He goes, Do you sweat glitter? You're so damn gay. You sweat glitter?
That's funny.
He doesn't laugh a lot. Joseph is a very serious person. He doesn't laugh a lot. So for him to laugh like that, it lit me up. I'm not joking. Like, it just made my day. But he was literally like, do you sweat glitter? Is that who you are now? And I was like, guilty. So this isn't my final form, but I have achieved the next level of gayness where you sweat glitter, apparently. Sorry, not sorry. Where do we go from here, you guys? Where do we go from here? I have absolutely nothing. I have no defense. I have nothing to say about that. Nothing at all. I mean, what am I gonna say? I haven't told my coworkers yet. I forgot to tell them. I'm going to tell them probably tomorrow. I'm going to do my morning announcements on the intercom and be like, hey, such and such do this and such do that. This is what we've got going on, blah, blah, blah. Projects, projects, projects. Oh, and by the way, I sweat glitter. This is who I am now. Yeah. I mean, what do you say in a moment like that? Now I know there are bad guys in here. Oh. Military grade duct tape and bottle caps? Yes, please. Okay, I'm detected. Oh, I see you. Oh shit, it's a legendary. Oh, and he mutated. Okay, bye. I need a silencer on this thing ASAP. There will be more. Bye! Go meet Ghoul Jesus. Technically, if you think about it, no, I'm not even gonna finish that. I'm not even gonna finish that. I feel like I'm gonna get canceled if I make that statement. But if you guys wanna hear the rest of that statement, hit me up on Twitter and I will finish that statement. In fact, just so I don't forget what I was about to say, I'm going to write it down on a sticky note. I've got so many sticky notes I'm starting to pile. I've been having to pull them and crinkle them up and throw them away because I've such a bad memory that sticky notes have become a staple of my life. I'm not joking. At work, at home, I'm surprised I don't have them in the car. I'm gonna write. I probably shouldn't even say this, but I put blank blank joke on Twitter. That's all I'm gonna say. I'm laughing at it because I already know the punchline. I know what it's about. It's hilarious to me, and I get it. You guys don't get it. So if you guys want to get it, hit me up on Twitter. Bye. Say bye-bye now. Come on down. And that's it. Okay. There will be more. We already know. We've been done new. But first, we gonna grab all this. Oh, I never knew there was a Nuka-Cola right there. I've always bypassed this machine entirely. How about them apples? Oh, backstory. Excuse me. There's a pulsar beacon here. You see this, right? This ghoul's head. So, look at that neck.
Yes.
Look at that neck.
It's like it's been...
There, now it's normal. Apparently, just needed a bullet in the back of it. He was like... He was just shrinky-dinked out, and as soon as I shot him, it just...
Now he straightens my head right now.
Anytime you need your neck cracked or anything, just a quick bullet... No, let me stop.
That's not...
I'm going to get myself in so much trouble today. Excuse me. I've got a piece of that damn... Whatchamacallit bar. That's literally what it's called, whatchamacallit. Excuse me. There's actually a pulsar beacon going off in here. Distress signal. And we're very, very close to it. In fact, there's a flight helmet. I love flight helmets. I forgot to turn that on. There is a distress signal here.
That was a blow tickler.
And we've started the Lost Patrol. It's a little side mission. Here it is right here. This is the distress pulsar. It says we're at 96%, but we're actually at 100. But if I pick it up, listen. Gone. Okay. Knight Aslan's holotape. I hate to actually take all her clothes, but I really like the Brotherhood of Steel outfit. I love something that's form-fitting, like a one-piece form-fitting outfit. I'm very much into, like, flight suits and stuff like that. I love that. Coveralls, anything like that. So, we're going to listen to that holotape. It's under Miss Knight Aslan's holotape. Here we go.
Terra Aslan, Brotherhood of Steel, Recon Team 429 Alpha, serial number 3431. It's been 3 hours since I set my distress pulsar. There's been no word from the Paladin or Ferris. Their objective was a satellite array on the coast. They may be out of range. My orders were to hold this position at all costs. The entire site has been overrun. The door won't last much longer. Paladin Brandis, sir. It's been an honor, sir.
All right, so we listened to her tape and we picked up a quest. And of course, you guys know, that's how we do here in Fallout. We listen to holotapes and we read notes and we learn about the world. Also, I may have leveled up and forgot to pick my points, so we might do that in a second. I could be wrong, I might have picked my points, I'm not sure.
That's it.
I'm just gonna grab all of it. And we got a pinup card, gardening. This card is desired by collectors and worth up to $100, so it's not really that much. It's a collectible, but it's not worth that much. No, we have already leveled up. Okay, we already picked up our perks. I could theoretically add a bunch more perk points, but I'm not about that life. Other than maxing out my specials to 10, to level 10, I don't believe in too much cheating. The only actual cheats I have going right now, there's a watch right there. I'm trying to, there we go. The only actual cheats I have going right now, you guys, is I maxed out my specials to 10 to start with. I don't like the fact that you have to worry about filling up all your points in your specials here to 10 stars before you're even able to start picking ways to play the game. Now, I don't fill up all of these. In fact, the only reason I'm doing this part right here is because I have a mod installed. I forget what it's called, but it adds, like, I believe it's called the 770 perk tree, something like that, where it adds a lot more different perks. Like, it takes something that would normally have 5 stars and makes it to 10. And instead of you doing plus 5, plus 10, plus 15, plus 20, I don't know my multiplication table. It does, like, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I know it. I was just talking while I was trying to do math. It halves it. Or actually, less than halves it. But it halves it and extends it and makes your... it's not super impactful to just get that plus 2%, but over time you feel like you're really working towards something. And like for instance, one of my favorites is like local leader. It's cut off some of the words, but it says, as a ruler everyone turns to, you're able to establish supply lines. That's fine. But you find some hidden synth files in an abandoned settlement. You now do plus 2% extra, it's supposed to say extra damage against synths. And every time you level it up, you'll do a little bit more damage to synths. And then eventually that'll change to something else. Like you're able to intimidate them in conversations if you have a conversation with them, stuff like that. And there's a whole bunch of additions and little tweaks and changes throughout the entire perk tree. And I feel like the mod author deserves like the mod author version of an Academy Award. Like honestly, they put a lot of time and extra effort into it, and they deserve all kinds of awards for that, because in my opinion, they didn't make it more difficult in the leveling. The leveling is slower in my opinion, which I applaud, because sometimes it can feel like you're just flying through the levels in the early stages. I feel like it kind of evens it out a little bit. And in my opinion, it actually enhances the RPG-ness of the RPG, which I personally never had a problem with the RPG-ness of this RPG. I never had a problem with it. But a lot of diehard Fallout players who have been Bethesda fanboys since long, long time ago, since the first games, have stated time and time again that Fallout 4 was a much easier version of the Fallout games. They dumbed it down, so to speak. And so stuff like this that overhauls the perks without really overhauling the game is a really good way to subtly and vastly overhaul the game without overhauling it. It changes the RPG-ness to a much more, you really can roleplay your character a little bit better. And there are other mods for that as well. Did I not open the door? I thought I opened the door. Security door control. Open door. I know I did. It just didn't take the first time. But yeah, there are other mods that you guys can download to really roleplay your character. One that I really like is kind of, it ties into really roleplaying your character, but also ties into the settlement building system, in that it's called Conquest. It basically allows you to build anywhere in the game that you want. But here's the thing, you don't have to build it as a settlement. You can literally set up just a temporary camp if you just need to store some stuff, empty your bags, role play. Like when the night falls, you build a campfire, you set out a tent and a sleeping bag and a generator with like a light or something, and you role play your character sitting there cooking dinner, sleeping in a sleeping bag until sunrise. Like that's a really interesting way of doing it. Or you can take that same camp that you made in the middle of nowhere and turn it into a flourishing settlement. I love that. That's a really cool way to role play in the game. I'm not going to eat any more of that right now. I'm going to actually close it up, because if I do, I'm going to start choking. It's hard to eat that and stream at the same time. How did this motherfucker see me? I barely moved. Bitch, just cut it out. I'm not trying to. And the other one's, of course, going to be hitting me. The other one's going to come through this door. This is one of the few times that you'll see. Let me talk about this one real quick. This is one of the few times in the game that you will actually see an enemy outside the area you're in run all the way to the front of the building, enter it, take a couple seconds, and then come through this door. That's so bizarre and also kind of cool. See, there he goes. He's going into that part of the building. He's running through. I just heard the door. I hit the wrong button. Thank you. like I said, it's one of the few times, actually, it might even be the only time in the game that you actually see that happen. And I think that is so cool. Honestly, I think that that's something that they should be putting in the game. Like, for all the future games, they need to do that. What is that? Oh, that's that card I see. I hear them. This is the part. These fuckers. I mean, I'm sneaking, and they just flat out hear me. How? How do they hear me? And I literally took one step. One. How do they hear me? Can they hear me talking? Is that what it is? I'll be quiet. I promise. Gotcha. There's no way we're not batting this. I'm sorry. Yeah, you can fuck all the way off with that bullshit. Those Reavers creep the hell out of me. I'm not joking. Like, I hate the Ghoul Reavers. Here he comes! I don't like it. I don't like it. I'm against it, and I'm unanimous on that. Okay. So that's a little bit better. There's a glowing one over there, I believe. Somewhere there's another one that sees me somehow. I don't know how, but it sees me. All right. We're going upstairs finally. I hate ghouls. They're so freaking fast. Fast like a freak. Now, I know there's one. Supposed to be one in this room, but we may have already, like, pulled it. Bitch! Ugh. I don't like that. Now, there's a radio going in here, but it's just static, so we're not worried about it. And also, this is one of the few places that you can find rum early on in the game, so I suggest you go ahead and grab it. Unlock National Guard officer password. What is this again? What is this? Remote door control. Oh. Yes, indeedy. We needed to unlock that door. All right, so there's a ghoul over there. There's a ghoul right there. We're going to kill that one by shooting its brain out. That's one less ghoul to deal with. And then, like I said, we're going to kill that one if we can. Oh, there's one right here. My bad. Fun fact about ghouls, doesn't matter if they're legendary or not, if you cripple one of their legs, they're still hostile, But they, unless you literally walk right up to them, they can't do nothing to you. I say fun fact. It's not necessarily fun. It's just, it is what it is. There's one in that room there, and then there's a glowing one down here that we're going to have to kill. I hear them. And the worst part is glowing ones can res the dead ones. Oh, hello there. Like that. I may have actually accidentally crippled Mama Glowing One here. Maybe not. We gotta kill her. Very quickly, before she has a chance to res these things. We got her. And we leveled up, yay! I am 1000%, we didn't kill all of them. I think there's, well no, that one that we just killed before her might have been the one from that bathroom. I think there's still like maybe one or two downstairs through that door right there. We'll find out in a minute. We will turn the light on so we can see. An enraging hardened sniper rifle? You guys, I like that. Okay, let's address something else real quick. I know I run my mouth a lot, but and I have a lot in this stream, and I've paused the stream a lot. The way they handle the legendary items that you get in Fallout 3, masterfully done, because it's a single player experience. It's not a live service. It's not constantly running. You can literally pause the game, although there are mods that can make it mimic a live service game. And for the longest time, I hated the way that they handled legendaries in Fallout 76. Yes, it is a Fallout game. No, it's not a pausable game. And so when you would be running around looting everything in the middle of a battle, all of a sudden almost the entirety of your screen would be taken up by that screen we just had when we picked up our legendary. You would still be able to like run around and do stuff while your screen's covered up. And so they recently patched that out to now whenever you, oh yeah, this guy is hotboxing Jet and he's an officer in the army. Oh, but now whenever you pick up a legendary, it will show up here, right about, oh, you can't see because where my portrait is down here, like right here where my face is, that's where the legendary effect now pops up. The item, the loot that you get, that's where it pops up. People could not be happier. Bethesda is, they very nearly lost everything, you guys. They very nearly lost everything. I'm just gonna say it. I don't think they realized how close they came to losing everything. But they did. I need to turn this light off, because I'm right above the area where I could lose everything. Did I loot that box, you guys? I did. Okay. All right, we are going. Another fucking legendary. Are you fucking kidding me? He didn't have time to mutate that time. I got a freaking tire iron. I want to be like, can you believe that? But Of course you can. I should have ignited the floor, but I didn't want to blow everything up and then possibly not be able to get a piece of loot. I hate explosions. I really do hate explosions. I mean, unless I'm in an area that I don't plan on looting. Ooh, yeah. I'm now permanently more difficult to detect while sneaking. I don't think so, because these ghouls, they knew where I was. I have two or three of these now. Not to mention, oh, we leveled up. Let's pick our perks. I'm a 4-star sneaker right here. Are you okay over there?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were coughing or something. He's laughing.
This video on Facebook of their floor.
Yes, Joseph Lately, and this is new for Joseph, you guys. I've kind of started not spending as much time on social media, and what's crazy is Joseph is picking up the slack. He's kind of becoming a messiah of the Book of the Face. Like, I don't understand, because for many, many days, I would be on Facebook just scrolling and, like, losing my mind, laughing and whatnot, and he's like, oh, you're on that damn Facebook. I'm like, yeah, it's hilarious. And now he's the one that's always laughing at shit on Facebook, and I'm like, what are you? And then I realize, oh, he's on there. Now, to be fair, my reaction isn't the same that his was. I'm not... What is... Wait. Something is still... All right, we're going to find out in a minute where it is and what it is. A tuxedo? Someone had a night out on the town planned. All right, let's see. I know he's in this bathroom. Not anymore. I generally end up coming to this location super early, so I always come and get those military fatigues and then put them on because, you know, you're playing a character who is ex-Army. It is Army, right? It's not Navy? But you're playing a character who is ex-Army, and to me, it only makes sense to be wearing fatigues. Now, that being said, as soon as I get a pair of Brotherhood... the onesie, the zippy onesie that the knights wear, I'm like, that's it. That's what I'm wearing. That's my outfit. I did get everything in here. Alright, so now... Alright, so the way this works is, you have a couple of different options. This is one of the few places that you can play the game, that after you clear it, you have, depending on how you play it, either way, you still have a guaranteed set of power armor, and I'll show you what I mean. Where's the door? Okay. So, you can go in here, right? You can go in here, and there's a set of power armor, right? But if you grab that power armor, you will trigger this big, big Billy Badass right here, this guy, and you'll have to fight a sentry bot. But if you just come over here and unlock this door, which I can't unlock it because I don't have expert unlocking, you can get that one, right? Or you can just do both and get both sets of power armor. Either one works. It's perfectly fine. However you want to play the game. It's your character, your game, you do what you want. What I do is I go into the National Guard Armory, I clear it, and then I don't grab either one because I don't like playing with power armor. You guys know this about me. Oh, wait. The door.
The door. As you're always saying, the door.
Shit. They're gonna set it off, all these laser tripwires. Maybe not. I've still got another one I have to kill. He's coming. I had to drop him before he could come on.
Yeah, I think you got him electric thing.
See these laser chirp wires?
Yeah.
They're gonna wake up that turret.
Oh,
Now, what I have to do is I have to disarm the tripwires. Even Joseph is paying attention now. And he never, never pays attention.
I do off and on. I just don't.
Off and on. I like how he says it. I do off and on.
Well, I mean, I'm on Facebook and stuff.
He's on the book of the face. I get it. You also trigger that Protectron over there. I can't shoot this ghoul who is officially losing his mind.
He's tweaking.
He's tweaking? Joseph is in it. He's involved today. He doesn't normally involve himself too much with Fallout. He'll watch me play, he's been watching me play Palia, and he really likes it. He'll watch me play ESO and Skyrim, and he's more into, even though he doesn't watch the stuff, normally, if he's gonna watch any of it, he'll watch me play the fantasy games that I play. He's not much for the science fiction-y stuff, although, what's weird is, you wanna know something crazy? This is how crazy this is. Joseph will watch science fiction TV shows, but not the science fiction games. He'll, not really watch fantasy at all, but watch me play fantasy games. Now, if only there was a game for, Stranger Things. He'd be in it to win it. He loves Stranger Things, you guys. He absolutely loves it. Now, I'm not going to go in there, even though there is, in fact, something in that bag that's probably a legendary and a somewhat shitty set of power armor and a workbench. We're not going in there, not right now anyway. We'll do it later. Right now, we've managed to unlock an area that has two functioning workbenches, an armor workbench and a weapons workbench. And if we go back out here, because we didn't trip any alarms and we didn't open that door, when we come back out here, theoretically... Oh, wait! Wait, he's running around. It did open up. He should have opened up. Okay, well, he's gonna die then. Wanna bet? He's got a skull over his head. He's so freaking powerful. Oh, now he knows I'm here. Now he knows I'm here. He said, oh, you think so? I don't. I try to keep the fence between us because then he can't actually get to me unless he goes around. And if you're careful, you can kite him without him getting physically close. Now, he can hit me with bullets if he so chooses. Yeah, he's going around the building and I'm still in bats. Oh shit, I didn't know there was an opening. Okay, we've exposed him a little bit. He feels so exposed. Oh, he's fixing to start something. He's getting ready to charge my ass. Oh, wrong button. Ah! Jesus Christ, he scared me. I wasn't ready. All right, we're gonna go for the head now. Not the face, not the face. He didn't like that. For some reason, I just got like the chills. Like, I feel like I'm facing off against a mechanical version of The Rock. I know that's so batshit crazy, but I am who I am. I said what I said, and you can deal with it. Damn. Let's shoot his arm off. Bam. He wasn't supposed to open up. Unless I'm wrong, which I never am. Oh shit! Are you kidding me? This day just gets better. That actually scared me more. It was the bloatfly. I wasn't expecting that. Is there anyone else? No? If there's any objection to the union between me and that power armor, speak now or forever hold your peace. I forgot about this guy I killed earlier. Okay, he's gone. All right, so the only other thing to grab, there is a bag of supplies right here. It's not a lot, but it's a good start. All right, we've cleared the area. I'll come back later. See, the reason why I don't grab freestanding things of power armor is because at my level, they're not going to be great. I mean, they're better than what I'm currently wearing, but I'm not a fan of power armor. I never, ever use it. Never, unless it's required or I'm role-playing. And B, at my level, it's going to be garbage. It's going to be T45. At the very lowest, T50 or 55. Whereas if I wait another 10 or 15 levels, I'll start getting XL1 power armor, which, again, I don't use power armor, but the XL1 series is prettier, in my opinion. I'm just going to say it. I said what I said. I don't think you're going to find too many people who will argue with me on that. The XL1 power armor is just prettier. It just is. All right, so these people here may or may not give me a quest. I don't know if any of you guys have been running into an issue like this, but sometimes you'll go up to a settlement and they'll have a quest for you to, like, unlock the settlement, right? And this guy obviously does.
You've got to help. They kidnapped my son.
Who?
Who kidnapped him?
They said they'd be back for the ransom.
Okay, so it's raiders. Okay, I prefer raiders over super mutants.
But I don't have.
Uh-oh.
Do you know where they took him?
I'm pretty sure. I'll mark it on your map.
Don't worry. I'll get him back.
Thank you. Thank you. I didn't know what I was gonna do. Just bring him back
safe. Oh, Monsignor Plaza. I wish that... You know what? I wish I could find... You know what? I wish they would tell you beforehand. I'm not a fan of this card here because you can't get the damn thing. No matter how close you get to it, you can't pick it up. I don't like that. Whoever did the mod, you did a good job. Except, wait. Oh, that's a Cambridge polymer I bought. I don't care about that. Okay, there are two beds. One settler. Wait. Who is that? We've got a random spawn over here, you guys. Wait. Gunners. Gun Teresias. Okay. We're gonna kill them in order. And then this one. Bitch. Gotcha. Now, I was under the assumption that one or three shots for the first two would kill them because it shows you the damage it's gonna do. Bitch. Okay, you gonna die now, bitch. Ragdoll, we love the ragdoll. That's just I don't care what's going on. That's just fun to watch. That was hilarious. That was a guy. I thought it was a girl. My bad. I like how the whole time I'm being shot at by gunners, there's one of those iBots running around just like, oh, Cambridge Polymer Labs. You know what I should do? I should try to get the iBot shot. I should try to get the iBot shot so he'll turn on the gunner. I wonder if you can do that. Dude, Mr. iBot's like, I'm out. I'm out. He said no. No. That would have been so cool. Oh, I should have run over there to see. Now the iBot's like, he's really wanting a sandbox. I really should have run over here and got that police protectron who's been investigating a murder-suicide for like the last 200 years. I probably shouldn't have said those words on my stream. That could get you in trouble. Oh, hello, Mr. Doggy Doggy. He's gone. He's with Doggy Jesus now. We sent him to a farm so he can laugh and run and play all day. Also, let me just say this. I have never understood why, when you get here to this location, this Protectron doing his job, investigating the scene, there's still a Brahmin walking around. Who's taking care of this Brahmin? I want to know. Like, I really want to know who's taking care of the Brahmin. In the meantime, yes. We are going to go. I bet you have to go back to Sanctuary. I do. No? Green Top Nursery. That's right. They sent me to the Air Force location. That's right. I forgot about that. I hear Joseph downstairs doing something. Alright, so now we're going to talk to someone who didn't even give us the quest. I don't know, she might have.
Were you able to clear out those ghouls?
Took care of those ghouls that were giving you trouble.
You did? That's great news! Bella, you and the Minutemen have our gratitude and our support.
Okay, good to know. She's probably going to end up being the mayor here. I'm just going to say that. Also, we're going to drop off all of our garbage. Although, we are going to keep the ASAM sensors. I wish I could, like, is there a way of, like, favoriting those to where they don't get dumped? Asking for a friend, and I'm the friend. All right, so now we got to go back to Sanctuary and tell Preston Garvey, because if we don't, he'll have a conniption. And after we tell him, of course, he's going to give us another location to go to, and then we'll have to end the show today, you guys. I'm really sorry. I'm having too much fun, but I do have to go to sleep. I have to be up at 2 in the morning for my day job, which sucks. It really does suck. I am enjoying the hell out of this. And I was like, who is this? Oh, what's her name? I don't know her name. That's just a Minuteman. That's Trash Can Carlos Brahmin. Here he is. Busy at work, not doing what he's supposed to be doing.
You ask me, freedom's always worth fighting for. I cleared out the ghouls that were giving that settlement trouble.
Glad to hear it, General. It's hard enough out here without people having to worry about ghouls in their backyard. I'll let you know if I hear of any settlements that need our help. In the meantime, make sure to offer help to anyone that needs it. That can only help our cause.
I am. See, you'll get to that. Wait. Oh, they're building something here. This is kind of exciting. It's a bunch of garbage puppies. It says armor. This is going to be a vendor. Oh, I'm excited. Super excited. I think these are visitors. I could be wrong, but these might be visitors. Visiting gambler.
Yeah.
And a Minuteman. As your towns grow, you will start attracting vendors. Not just vendors, but like you'll start attracting all kinds of people. And like you see this person here, this settler,
looking for trouble,
is cleaning up a little bit. And this person is a visiting farmer. They're using the newspaper as a pillow. They're actually, see, I've always wondered why they don't use couches and benches as beds. I've slept on a couch many a night. Not like on purpose or in trouble. Joseph and I have this very big rule. Even when we're fighting, we sleep together in the bed. That's just, we have two rules for the bed, actually, and they're both completely fine. Anyone can hear this. It's not bad for children or adults or anyone to hear. Doesn't matter. We don't really like going to bed angry, you know, so we always sleep in the bed together, even when we're ill with each other or with life in general. And the other thing is, when we sleep at night, our feet or our hands have to be touching. That's just a thing that we do. It's usually our feet. And that's just how that is. All right, so I thought he was going to give us another settlement needing our help quest, but I'm glad he didn't, because that gets old after a while of just doing fetch quests, basically. Also, I like having player autonomy. You know, I like player choice. I like being able to do what I want to do, which honestly, I kind of want to do one. But that's not the point. I want to be able to do it because I want to do it. No, what it is, this is what I was going to say. You will start reaching a point where, there are still plenty of locations, settlements, but you'll reach a point where he won't be giving them to you quite as much. You'll be getting them from the castle. And then once you start getting more and more of the settlements unlocked, it'll slow down and they'll be like, it's up to you to find the people that need help. Now I believe we had to give Jake a day or two to come back, and he'll have figured out the situation with Concord. Now, it is currently 12:41 p.m. It's a little too early to be sleeping to the next day, so we're not going to. But what we are going to do is check out... This is a vendor, if I'm not mistaken. Power Armor Merchant. Yes, it's starting to get cleaned up a little bit. I like this. All right, we're gonna talk to him.
Hi, are you looking for something to wear?
How are things going?
Well, if you're asking, food's been short around here lately. It's hard to think about anything else when you're hungry all the time.
What's burning?
I cleaned the stove up down there.
Okay, it just came up through the vents, I guess, when the air cut on. I was about to panic, you guys. Okay, we're gonna start that over. He said food was a little short. So, if you talk to everyone in your town at some point and ask them what the news is or how things are going, they'll tell you stuff like that. Food's been short, or water's been low, or there's not enough security, or the power has been fritzing out. That is a clue to you to go fix that problem. So, before we leave, we need to go to the mayor's table, and we need to donate some food. All right, now he sells, it looks like, a bunch of everything. He's got some a Molotov cocktail. He's got, okay, here we go. He's selling T-45, regular T-45B and T-45C stuff, and he's got one T-51B helmet. Now, as the store upgrades over time, the more and more you play the game and the more settlers that show up and the more the town upgrades itself, you'll find that his wares will not only increase, but get better. And that's for all of your... He'll even sell you a power armor frame. How about that? It's worth 3,300 caps. We're not doing that, but I'm just saying, like, you can buy things. And he's also got mods. Titanium plating and a VATS matrix overlay, which... I don't know what that does, honestly. He sells fusion cells and fusion cores, fully charged, mind you. That's pretty good. I don't need any of this, but I just wanted to show you his wares.
Some days are harder than others, but even the hard days get easier than the one before.
Poor June, he's been through it. Okay, so this over here, it's still the player home, which I appreciate, but the mayor's desk is also in here, which is weird because Preston is the mayor. And he's not using the bed. This is still my bed. Okay, so we're going to donate some items, which is, we're gonna donate food. All right, we're going to... You know what? Let's give him a beer. Let's... I'm going to give them some food and some alcohol. Their lives are hard enough. They should be able to let loose a little bit. All right, we're going to give them... Dandy Boy apples. Fancy lead snack cakes. Ice cold Gwinnett. I'm not going to give them that. No, I'm not... I'm going to give them some purified water, I think. Do I have any? Oh, yeah, I got a little bit. I can give them, like, 10. And I'll give them these pork and beans and crisps. And the potted meat. And they gave the potted meat and the beer back. And the tater crisps. But they're probably going to give it all of it back. It looks like they gave the water back, the Instamash, all that. Yeah, it looks like everything I gave them, they're giving back. Even though the guy said food scarce. Yeah, that's nice. Alright, so I guess this is where we're gonna leave it, you guys. Just for now. Here's our guy. He looks a lot bigger than he really is, but he's wearing, like, the biggest kind, that like, heavy leather armor. And that also adds layers. I don't know why he looks so freaking fat. He's just Potato, isn't he? I should change his name to Potato. Let's just say that. All right, so let's save. Because I know it did save just a minute ago, but Bethesda. Just gonna say that. I had so much fun, you guys. This really was a fun stream. I had a lot of fun. Even Joseph had fun today. It was super quiet in chat. Not a single person chatted today.
Wow.
Honestly, that hurt my feelings a little. But not like, I'm not dying about it. Because sometimes in the game, I get so caught up in stuff that I forget to look at chat. That's also been a big critique from Eric. He's always like, you need to interact with your chat more. I'm not here for that. I don't always have to interact with my chat. Sometimes I just want to run my mouth and be funny while playing my game. I do talk to you guys. I love talking to you guys, but that's not the goal here. I have fun having an audience and interacting with y'all, but sometimes I just want to play the game while you guys watch. And that seems to be what happened today, which is fine. That's totally fine. So we're not streaming tomorrow, Sunday, obviously. But Monday we will pick back up. We may do some more Fallout, actually. I'm not feeling very World of Warcraft-y. I play a lot of World of Warcraft off camera. And so when I'm on camera, I like playing stuff that is a little different. I've been playing a lot of Warcraft and Palia and Shop Titans. And a little bit of Baldur's Gate 3. That's a lot of fantasy. So on the days that I stream, I do something different. So I'm like, you know what? Let's play some Fallout. We may continue Fallout until Starfield, which is less than a month away. It comes out globally September 6th, but I'm going to have early access to that. So, I believe up to a week prior. So at the end of this month, probably, or the very, very first day of September, I'll be playing Starfield early. I will be streaming it. God willing, I will be streaming it. And we'll go from there. In the meantime, I had a lot of fun. I appreciate everyone. Thank you to the new follower, Athena. You're the MVP of the show today. Thank you to Hoppy and our little bobblehead. Thank you to my whatchamacallit bar that very nearly ended my life earlier. And thank you to Daddy Joseph for being on the location today. Being here, being present, laughing his ass off,
yeah. And
having a blast. And thank you to all of you who watch this later on either here or on YouTube. You guys are really the unsung heroes of my channel. I don't have as much interaction live, but I get a lot more interaction after I hit in stream. People watch these videos. I get messages from people. I'm getting a bigger following on Facebook, on Twitter, and on Snapchat. Speaking of which... Guys, I love seeing the stuff that you guys send me on Snap and Instagram. Like, I love that. I love seeing what games you're playing. I love seeing your characters, what builds, what kind of talents you pick. I like seeing the things that you do outside of your life. Like, I've got some people that follow me on Snap and Instagram who show me all kinds of food. I basically get to virtually go on vacation with these people. They show me the food trucks they go to. They show me the beaches they go to. That is so awesome. Thank you so much from the bottom of my cold, dead heart. That being said, if you're going to send me anything, make sure it's stuff like that. Do not send me corn. You know what I'm saying? I'm cleaning it up so this doesn't get demonetized. But don't send me non-family-friendly material. Don't send me NSFW. Don't send me that kind of stuff. I don't want to see that kind of stuff. If I wanted to see that kind of stuff, the interwebs is there. If I wanted to see that stuff in person, I have something for that. You know? I see enough of that every time I get in the shower. I don't need to see that on my phone. Because I always get notifications, and there's been a couple of times I've been at work and went to check and see what, oh, XYZ has sent me on what game they're playing, and instead, it's something else. Please be clean. Please be respectful. That's all I'm asking. In the meantime, thank you guys so much. I had so much fun, and I will catch you guys on Monday at 4 o'clock, where we will continue our Fallout adventure. We will just, I think we're just going to play some Fallout for a while. We're enjoying this Sim Settlements 2 playthrough. So you guys have a great day. And remember what I always say at the end of my shows. Be safe, be kind, and happy hunting.